Joining us now to speak a little bit more about policy and advocacy work is Crystal Gadegbeku, Chair of Policy and Advocacy Committee, and Scott Bieber, Chair of the Quality Committee. Thank you both for being here this morning.
Thank you for having us.
So let's start with the executive order on advancing American kidney health, and all of its components make this a very exciting time to be a part of Kidney Week. From the perspective of policy and advocacy, can you elaborate a little bit more on exactly what this executive order is?
So the executive order really is, its intention is to revolutionize care and the way we take care of patients, as well as spawn and spur innovation, re-engineer transplantation, and increase awareness. So we're really in a new era. And we're really excited about this, because about 3-4 years ago, we started to, as value-based care was coming into effect, we started to think about how we would want to take care of patients, and what is the ideal way we'd like to see change in the kidney space. And so we got a lot of feedback from many, many stakeholders to understand that, and came out with kind of a concept of what we wanted to do. So we were very happy when the executive order came out. It's so aligned with the ideals and things that we were already thinking about, which made it very exciting. The executive branch really understands the urgency of the problem, and that something needs to be done for change, and have come up with some really ambitious goals.
Wonderful. And Scott, when it comes to the regulatory side of things, how does that executive order affect what you do?
Well, the ASN Quality Committee is heavily involved in analyzing the regulations that come out of HHS that are attached to this executive order. So these are quite complicated regulations typically, and it takes a whole staff of people from ASN to really sort through those. We also have a committee which involves about 12 people who advise the ASN policy staffers on how ASN can respond to these regulations that are coming down from the government. It takes a lot of work, and people dedicate their time. We have a great group of individuals from all over the country that look at these regulations and feedback to the ASN staffers, which ultimately informs the response that goes to the ASN Council. It helps ASN be a part of the discussion as these regulations come out from the government.
And so we already know what's on the books when it comes to regulations already. Can you talk a little bit about some of the policy work that ASN is currently involved in?
Sure. So this executive order is just that. It's an order that guides the national strategy for kidney health. But much has to be put in place to do that. And one thing that Scott and I always talk about is the fact that it needs funding to be able to do it. And so that's where our work really comes in. So as the policy committee, we are responsible for advocating for the funding that will need to be put in place to make the executive order really be realized.
And you're talking about the things that are being rolled out. How will these new developments end up helping the future of kidney care?
I think the new developments really align what we're doing in kidney care with what the patient is interested in. I mean, we were talking about providing alternate options for therapy through programs like KidneyX, where people have access to wearable artificial kidneys, bioengineered kidneys, advancing the science that can really help patients move forward and live more productive lives. We're talking about investing more in research for kidney disease. We're talking about trying to come up with payment models that incentivize care in the home, as well as kidney transplantation. So these are all things that our patients are asking us to do. So it's so great to see that the executive order is aligned with what we think patients need.
And how can ASN members get involved in policy or advocacy work, should they want to?
Oh yeah, definitely.
I'm sure we'd be encouraged.
Absolutely. We represent the community, and the community is diverse and has, you know, we're all of common mission and common goal, as Scott spoke of, to take care of patients and to advance kidney care. But we all practice in different environments, academic to small, city to urban. And I think it's so important for us to hear from the community so that we can best represent when we go to the Hill, or best have their thoughts in mind as this whole initiative is rolled out.
All right, Crystal Gadegbeku and Scott Bieber, thank you both so much for your time this morning. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.